Hello friends, welcome to this video lecture about chronological evolution to Consumer Protection Act. Let me first introduce myself. I am Dr. Nishant Barapatre, working as a lecturer in Sheth JP Government Ayurved College, Bhavnagar, Gujarat. In this lecture, we will see how the medical law has chronologically evolved from the times before Christ to the most recent Consumer Protection Act. Let's begin the talk by remembering those good old days, especially in India, when the doctor was considered to be a god and the medical profession as a noble profession, gaining lots of respect from the society. This is because the doctors always deal with the human life, protecting them from countless diseases and provide a good quality of life. The nobility of the medical profession reflects in the ethical guidelines thrust upon them, not by any law, but by the profession itself. These ethical guidelines help to maintain the nobility of the profession. However, with the changing times, due to the expansion of education and easily accessible sources of information like internet and social media, the patients are increasingly gaining knowledge about different aspects of medical field. So there is an increase in public awareness about their health as well as their consumer rights. In one sense, this knowledge is good if the public can identify between a quack and a qualified doctor. But this has led to a changing tendency in the people to misjudge a doctor as negligent even after a doctor has made all the possible efforts towards the patient. So now, when the Consumer Protection Act has come into action since 1986, the patient is now considered as a consumer and a doctor is believed to be a professional only who is obliged to provide the services of healthcare. As the Consumer Protection Act provides a simplified way to register a complaint, and there is only a minimal fees for this, maximum up to rupees 500. Hence, there has been an increase in the number of allegations of medical negligence against the doctors. However, it seems to be the same old story more or less. There have been guidelines for good medical practices across the ages. But whenever these ethical guidelines have been disobeyed by some of the physicians, or when there was emergence of quacks along with the time, then there had been laws and regulations to keep a command on the physicians, and also execution of penalties in case of gross mistakes. On the chronological timeline, we find the Code of Hammurabi as the oldest known written medico-legal code, which existed around 2000 BC. Hammurabi was the great king of Babylon, who had formulated a set of drastic laws to regulate the conduct of physicians and the health practices. Though he was kind enough to make a provision for the fees payable to physicians for their satisfactory services, but he had also imposed brutal penalties on the physicians in case their therapy proved harmful. Such doctors faced the risk of being killed. Like the Babylonian Code of Hammurabi, even the Egyptian and Roman law of that time had similar provisions, like to cut the hands of the physician for causing death or serious injuries to the patient. In Samhita period, that is the period of Charak and Sushrut Samhita, which is supposed to begin approximately 1000 BC onwards, we find some references indicating that the medical profession at that time was quite similar to what it appears today. There have been ethical standards prescribed for the medical practice. There was a tradition of taking oath for the ethical conduct as well. Even the process of registration of doctors can be observed, but still the unethical practices were prevalent even in that period. All the ancient sages of Ayurveda have given utmost importance to the physician among the four limbs of treatment. A physician is said to be the foremost and ahead of the drugs, nursing staff and the patient, because he is Vigyata, Shasita and Yokta, which means he possesses specific knowledge, administrative capacity and managerial skills. The present day case law also holds only a physician responsible for medical negligence and not the junior doctors and nursing staff, because the physician is the sole master to take medical decisions. Ayurveda emphasizes on the four basic qualities to be possessed by a physician, which are must for him to qualify as a good physician. These include the proficiency in theoretical knowledge, extensive practical experience, dexterity, and purity of body and mind. Even today, the law expects a doctor to possess these qualities as a reasonable degree of skill and knowledge and a reasonable degree of care. Around 1000 BC, sage Agnivesha has formulated an oath for the ethical conduct in medical profession. This oath had to be taken by a student before he begins to study medicine. It has been explained in Charak Samhita and therefore is known as Sage Charaka's oath. Though it's not a lawful compulsion, but it's an ethical binding on all the medical students even before they begin their medical education. To keep a check on medical profession, the procedure of doctor's registration was undertaken in the ancient times as well. A doctor needed to register himself after the completion of his education by getting permission from the king, and then only he could start his own medical practice, like we register today in our respective councils. But whenever the control over the kingdom had been loose on part of the king, there was emergence of quacks who exploited the conditions and settled themselves as doctors in the society. We find the evidences of unethical practices in the Samhita Granthas. Charak Samhita points out that getting a treatment from quacks could worsen the patient's condition, so it's better to succumb to the death instead. Even though this statement seems to be an exaggeration, but it effectively depicts the situation of that time. Sage Sushruta has also explained about the quacks, for which he has used many different words such as Vaidya Vidagdha, Kuvaidya, Murkha Vaidya and Taskar Vrutti. As Sage Charaka Jot established medical ethics in ancient India, the Hippocratic Oath did the same in ancient Greece. Hippocrates, who lived between 460 to 370 BC and often called as father of medicine, has formulated the famous oath which has become a keystone of medical ethics. This shows that the ethical nature of medical profession was a global scenario and not a limited one. Around 4th century BC, Chanakya has compiled Kautilya Arthashastra, which is a book on statecraft, economics, and defense policies. In one of its sections, named Kantak Shodhanam, which means apprehension of the criminals, a body of counsel has been described, consisting of three pradeshta, that means magistrates, and three amatya, that is government officers from the ministry. The objective of this council was to solve the disputes among the public and apprehend the criminals. In the next few chapters of this section named Kantak Shodhanam, we find the first reference in the Indian medicine about penalties for the mistakes of the physicians. It is mentioned that a critically ill patient should be treated only after reporting to the authorities. Because if the patient dies, then the physician will get a mild punishment for his overconfidence. If the death of the patient occurs due to the mistakes of the physician, then he will be punished moderately. And in the case of grievous injury or loss of body part of the patient, the physician will be given a severe punishment. Again, Kautilya Arthashastra advocates the punishments for criminal abortion as well. If abortion is done by impacting some object, then severe punishment will be given. If it's conducted by medicines, then the physician will be moderately punished. And if it's done by causing agony to the lady, then there will be mild punishment. Even in case of epidemics and injuries, Kautilya Arthashastra suggests that a physician should first report to the concerned authorities without treating such a patient secretly. Otherwise, he will be held guilty just like a criminal. In this way, since the period of Kautilya Arthashastra, we find stringent laws and regulations for the medical profession. In the book Manusmriti, which probably followed Kautilya Arthashastra, somewhere in between 4th and 3rd century BC, we find ample of laws created by King Manu, who was a famous lawmaker in the ancient India. Most of these laws are related to the social conduct of Hindus. However, it has been stated that if a physician makes some mistakes, then he needs to make a confession of that in front of the Almighty. Subsequent to the Manusmriti, Narad Smriti depicted a period approximately between 1st century BC to 4th century AD, where we find references about the formulation of judiciary bodies for the public. The structure of the judiciaries was quite similar to the court of law, which comprised of the king, chief judge, assessors, accountant, writer or scribe, etc. There was a hierarchical structure of the judiciary bodies like Gram Sabha, Pura Sabha and Raj Sabha, which also provided the provisions of appeals. Narad Smriti also describes the judicial procedure of that time in minute details, which was very similar to the court procedure today. There was a provision of redressal for faulty goods as well, which can be said to be a pioneer application of the Consumer Protection Act. The faulty goods had to be either exchanged by the seller or the price of the goods had to be paid back to the customer. The first ever case documented under English law was in the year 1374 against a surgeon J. Mert, when the plaintiff had an injury in his hand due to the wrong treatment. In United States, the first case was recorded in the year 1794. The case is known as Dr. Cross versus Guthrie. In this case, patient's husband sued the physician Dr. Cross when the patient died as a result of post-operative complications of mastectomy. A compensation of £40 was given to the plaintiff. In the modern times, in 1860, Indian Penal Code came into existence. However, 10 years later, in 1870, IPC was empowered with Section 304A, which set out a provision of punishment to the medical personnel causing death due to negligence. It has been stated in Section 304A that whoever causes the death of a person by doing any rash or negligent act not amounting to the culpable homicide shall be punished with imprisonment up to 2 years or with fine or with both. The World Medical Association, which is an association of the national medical associations of all countries, holds annual assemblies at different cities. In its second assembly at Geneva in September 1948, it adopted an ethical declaration, famously known as the Declaration of Geneva. This declaration was implemented in response to the unethical and inhuman experiments committed by the doctors in Nazi Germany. This declaration consisted of a physician's oath regarding consideration of patient's health and humanity at the prime level. It was intended as a modification of the Hippocratic Oath that could be implemented in the modern times. The Declaration of Geneva has been amended time to time and has been followed by MCI as a code of medical ethics in India. In 1956, the Indian Medical Council Act was constituted by the Government of India. It has prescribed the professional standards and etiquettes and a code of ethics for medical practitioners. In the cases of professional misconduct, the registration of a doctor can be cancelled under this Act and a commission of inquiry can be conducted under the Code of Civil Procedure. However, the jurisdictions by MCI had been biased in favor of the doctors and they didn't have the rights to serve compensation. On the other hand, jurisdictions by civil and criminal courts were time-consuming and expensive. As both these systems failed to serve efficiently, it was high time for a more competent law like the Consumer Protection Act. The Consumer Protection Act was brought by the Government of India in 1986. Mainly to control and reduce the unfair trade practices and to provide an easy, cheap, speedy and effective redressal of the consumers' complaints. Though the Act was passed in 1986, initially the medical services were not included in it. In 1995, by the landmark judgment of Supreme Court of India, in the case इंडियन मेडिकल एसोसिएशन वर्सेस वीपी शांता, द मेडिकल प्रोफेशन वॉज ब्रॉट इन द एम्बिट ऑफ कंज्यूमर प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट. द सुप्रीम कोर्ट हेल्ड दैट अ पेशेंट इज ऑल्सो अ कंज्यूमर एंड देयरफोर ही कैन गो टू एनी कंज्यूमर डिस्प्यूट्स रिड्रेसल एजेंसी एंड कैन मेक एन अपील अगेंस्ट मेडिकल निग्लिजेंस एंड डेफिशियंसी इन सर्विस. The Consumer Protection Act was amended in the following years, in 1991, 1993, and 2002. The 2002 amendments have brought up major changes with many new provisions like the enhanced pecuniary limits of jurisdiction. It has made the condition worse for the medical profession, as there has been a high increase in the number of litigations admitted after 2002. Also, there has been a higher amount of compensation claimed by the complainants, and the tendency to withdraw the cases or mutual settlements has also been diminished. In this way, we land into the present scenario of Consumer Protection Act, which is now bossing the whole medical profession. This medico-legal evolution of the medical profession has taken a time span of about 4,000 years, 2,000 years before Christ and 2,000 years Anno Domini. Therefore, taking a bird's eye view as a whole, a chronological sequence of this evolution can be established, and the progression of medical profession can be traced from its early days to till date. We observe that the medical profession has a long-standing tradition of ethical standards and a disdainful tradition of quackery and unethical conduct as well. Even the laws to regulate the medical profession and curb the unethical practices have been present throughout this period. Thus, to conclude, I would say that the medical profession had just evolved gradually to the times of sophisticated regulatory bodies and application of laws like Consumer Protection Act. However, the medico-legal principles of the profession have remained constant throughout its period of evolution and shall continue to be the same in the coming times as well. Thank you.